Hi to you. Where does this sperm formation takes place? So, who will decide the baby who is going to born, is a boy or a girl? Who is going to decide that? And what is the pathway of this sperm? And what is the structure of it? So, what is the system included in all these parts? So, that we are going to tell about now. So, what is the system of that? So, that is none other than the male reproductive system. So today we are going to learn about that. So, but before that, let me introduce about me to you. So, my name is B.C. Poshika, studying in 10th class in BMS Institution in Raidur. So, let us know about that now. Come. So, this is the structure of the male reproductive system. So, it includes many parts, right? So, now let us start from the testes. So, here you are seeing that, right? So that is the structure of the testes. But if we zoom in into this, then it just looks like this. So it includes some parts. So now I am going to tell about that to you. See here, the structure that you are seeing is the structure of the testes. So here the membrane which is outside the testes, that is known as the tunica vaginalis. So this membrane is known as the tunica vaginalis and it is outside of the testis. And there is also another membrane which is present and which is enclosing the testis, that is tunica albuginea. So the another membrane, so it is not just like the membrane, but it is the enclosing of this testis. So it will be like the enclosing and also it is closely inverted. So it is closely inverted because it has to create some septum because it has to divide the lobes. So for that, it is present inside the testis. And also see the valves which are here are known as septum. And now, coming to the lobules, so this structure which you are seeing here are known as the lobules. So these are the lobules which are present here and those are known as the testicular lobules. See, this type of lobules are known as testicular lobules. So these lobules are nearly 250 in each testis. And see, in this testicular lobules, there will be 2 to 3 highly coiled seminiferous tubules. But what is this seminiferous tubules? They are just like network-like structures with the tubes. So they just look like this, like a membrane-like structure. And see, in this, the formation of this sperm takes place. And now, this is all about this part. Coming to the rectal testis, and after the rectal testis, there will be vasa efferentia, and after the vasa efferentia, the epidermis which is present here. So this is known as the epididymis. And do you know that in this epididymis there are 3 parts? Those are lappet and corpus and cauda. So these are the 3 parts which are divided in this epididymis. So these are the 3 parts. I think you all have known about this. Now see what happens after this structure. So this is all about the structure of the testis. Now let us know that what is the sac which is present outside the testis. So that is scrotum sac. So the scrotum sac is very helpful for the testes to protect it by that also. And also it is very helpful that it is outside the body, that means it is below the abdominal cavity. So it is below the abdominal cavity because there is a reason being there, because it has to maintain a low temperature below than our body normal temperature. So we know that our normal body temperature is vary from this soprotum sac temperature. So it will maintain 2 to 2.5 degree Celsius less than the actual temperature of our body. So that is why they are being below the abdominal cavity of the male reproductive system. And also see, now coming to the vasa deferentia. So this is known as the vasa deferentia. And this is a long narrow tube and it is also a muscular tube. Now see where it is leading to. So along through this way if you go, then it will lead to the seminal vesicle. And what about this seminal vesicle? So what is there in this seminal vesicle and what does it produce? So this seminal vesicle is the thing that produces seminal fluid. So it produces nearly 60% of the seminal fluid for this sperm. So this is about the seminal vesicle, and also it is just like a viscous fluid and it is also alkaline, but it contains protein, citric acid, fructose and also potassium and inorganic phosphorus and also prosthetic glands. So these are all the things that which it includes in this seminal vesicle gland. And after that, so when these vasodeferentia and the seminal vesicle combine, they form the ejaculatory duct. So as it is the seminal vesicle, when this vasodeferentia and the seminal vesicle combine, they form the ejaculatory duct. So this is known as the ejaculatory duct. And after that, after the ejaculatory duct, when it moves forward, then it will reach to the prostate gland. And this prostate gland will also give some of the semen which is necessary for this sperm. So it will give nearly 15 to 30% semen for this sperm. And what is there in the semen? So it includes, it is just like acidic in nature, and also it will activate the spermatozoa, and also it will give the nutrition to this sperm. So that is what this prostate gland will do. And after that, where this gland on the after that ejaculatory duct forms, and after that it will come to one way and it will mix with the urethra. And this is the urethra. As you are seeing here, this is the urethra, and they both combine and they form the urethra. Again they lead to the penis. So this is the structure of the penis. And do you know that this penis has foreskin? So we can say that this penis is very helpful for the ejaculation of the semen into the vagina. So that is what all about this penis. And I hope you understood about this male reproductive system. But when we know about that, it is also very important to know about the structure of the sperm and also the what is the pathway of the sperm. So these are all the things that you need to know about when you are knowing about the male reproductive system. So that is why now I am going to tell about the structure of the sperm. Okay, let us know about the structure of the sperm. See, this is the structure of the sperm that what you are seeing on the board right now. See, this is the structure of the sperm. And the sperm has mainly three parts. Those are head, middle part and the tail. So what is there in this head? So it includes two parts, mainly those are acrosome and the nucleus. This acrosome is very helpful for the sperm for giving the protection to the nucleus, and also it will help the sperm to penetrate into the ovum while penetrating into the ovum. So, and it also has some enzymes in it like acidic phosphatase and also some of the enzymes. So, and after that, coming to the nucleus. So, this nucleus contains genetic material, we all know that. But do you know that it only contains 23 chromosomes? Just contains 23 chromosomes. See, they are just 23. don't get confused that they might be 23 of pair. So they are not in the pair of 23, they are just singly 23 in number, they are not a pair. Okay, so that is what we have to think about, but that it is not in the pair, it is just 23 in number. And coming to the neck, so it also has a neck and it has mitochondria in its middle part, because these mitochondria are very useful for the sperm because of the mobility. So it has to move, means, see, whatever we do, see, we should get some energy for working or any other things that what we do. So like that, this sperm also will get energy from this mitochondria. Will provide the energy for this sperm to move. And also coming to the neck, tail. So this tail is also helpful for the sperm to move forward. So this is about the structure of the sperm, and these are all the parts that which are included in this sperm. Now what is the pathway of this sperm, that how does it move and where does it go and where does it mixes with the other secretions, and let us know about that, okay? See, now first of all, this sperm will take place, means the formation of this sperm takes place in the seminiferous tubules. So these are seminiferous tubules. So in the seminiferous tubules, the formation of this sperm takes place. So where does it go after this formation of this sperm? So they go to the epididymis through the vasa efferentia and also the rete testis. After that, it will enter into the epididymis. As I told that there will be three parts in this epididymis, right? So those are caput, corpus and cauda. So these are the three parts of this epididymis. But the development of this sperm will take place only in one part, that is caput. So this is the part that where the development of these sperms takes place. And also it will be stored in that place until it has to go outside of the body. So after that, when it has to go outside of the body, where does it go? So after that, it will enter into the vasa deferentia. So this is the vasa deferentia that you are seeing here, is the vasa deferentia. As I told that it is a long tube and also a muscular one. Now see, it will enter into the vasa deferentia and it will travel through the vasa deferentia. So what is the travel through? So the sperm will travel through the vasa deferentia and enters and mixes with the seminal fluid. I told that seminal vesicle contains seminal fluids which will give 60% of the fluid to this sperm, right? Now see, it will mixes with the fluid which will be created by the seminal vesicle. Now it will mixes with that, and do you know that fructose is very helpful for the sperm, because when it goes outside of the body, then it will give the energy to the sperm to move forward. Okay, so that is one of the work of the fructose that it is doing. And also coming to this part, now the sperm has entered to the ejaculatory duct by mixing with the seminal fluid and also the sperm. So now coming to this prostate gland, and the prostate gland will give 15 to 30% of the semen to the sperm, and also as I told that it will give the energy and also it will give the nutrition and it will activate the spermatozoa. Now they both will combine here and they enter through the urethra, and they finally, while ejaculating, the bulbourectal glands, they will release some fluid which is useful for that. So it will release only the fluid when during the ejaculation, only that will release this fluid. So after that, this spermatozoa semen will travel through this urethra and goes out of the body through the penis. So as I told, the penis is the important thing to ejaculate this semen into the female's body. So after this, it will enter into the vagina through this penis. So that is, we are going to discuss about that in the female reproductive system. So now I hope you all have understood my teaching, and I thank you very much for giving this opportunity, and thank you for watching the video. Thank you.